So you're a developer, and therefore, of course, you know how to write code with a certain programming language, with some libraries, frameworks, and so on. But what else do you need to know? So which other tools do you need to know? Do you need to know how to work with Git? Do you need to know how to work with the terminal, the command prompt? Do you need to know advanced commands there? Do you need to know Linux? Do you need to have sophisticated knowledge about all the features your code editor may offer? Do you need to know Docker? And so on. Which tools or what else besides the core technology you're working with do you need to know? That's an interesting question, I think, because there definitely are a lot of different opinions on that out there, and here's my opinion on that. And I would say that, for example, you definitely need to know how to work with Git, because version control is an essential skill, or being able to use version control systems is an essential skill as a developer, not only because you'll need it in basically every job you'll work with, I guess, though I actually do know a company who uses, I think, Dropbox and copy and pasting for version control, but yeah, in most jobs you will need that. But besides that, it also helps you for all your side projects, all your experiments, all your demo projects when you're building a portfolio and so on. It definitely helps because being able to create snapshots, being able to go back to an older code snapshot, being able to work with branches, and knowing how to work with all these different Git features is an essential skill, I would say, no matter with which programming language or framework you might be working with. But of course, besides Git, you then also could ask the question whether you need to know how to work with GitHub. And you could also ask the question what exactly you need to know about Git. Only the most basic commands, like creating commits and working with branches, or also advanced commands. And here I would argue that you don't necessarily need any advanced knowledge or any advanced Git or GitHub skills. You should definitely know how to work with it, what it is, and how you do create commits and so on. You should know how to work with GitHub, at least the essentials, how to create repositories, how to manage repository access. You should know what a pull request is and why it may be useful, especially when working in a team or on an open source project. But I would argue that you don't need to know how to cherry pick with Git or how to do any advanced work where you wanna check out one file from an older commit, because if you ever need to do something like that, you can Google it or ask an AI, I guess. So, of course, you'll then learn it when you'll need it, though you also might forget it thereafter. At least for me, I know that I have done things with Git which I wouldn't be able to do now anymore, but I don't think that it is part of your core skill set or that these things need to be part of your core skill set. And the same is true for GitHub. For example, GitHub Actions can be super useful, and I would argue that they can be helpful in many projects, being able to set up automated workflows that run upon pushes and so on can be useful, but it's definitely not an essential skill that every developer needs to have. You don't need to know how to work with GitHub Actions, and you also don't need to know about all these niche Git features and all these fancy things you can potentially do with Git. Because, of course, if you don't have advanced knowledge, you might end up doing certain things in an unnecessary complex way, You might not always find the quickest and smartest solution, but ultimately, it is often about finding a solution. And therefore, having a good foundation is important, but you don't need to be a Git expert just to call yourself a developer, I would argue. Because, I mean, if you take a look at the official Git documentation, there are thousands of options and flags you can add to all these commands, and I know probably almost none of those, I would argue. So that's my opinion on that. Now, of course, Git is not the only thing you'll use as a developer. You also often work in the terminal, the command prompt. And again, you could ask the question how well you should know it. And again, I would argue that the very basics are enough for many developers. You don't necessarily need to know advanced commands that allow you to search all files that contain a certain piece of text in their file name and then pipe another command onto that to use that output of the first command and the second command and so on. You don't need to know that, in my opinion. Because again, if you have a specific use case where you need to do something like that, you'll find a fitting command by searching for it or by asking an AI. You then should just be able to at least roughly understand what the command will do so that you don't accidentally delete your entire file system or something like that. But that is enough, in my opinion. You don't need to be an expert. If you enjoy diving deeper, that's of course a different thing. That's absolutely fine, but it's not a fundamental skill you need to have that you call yourself an expert in the command line. I don't think that this is a crucial skill where you need to excel, at least again, in my opinion. And you can probably see where I'm going with that. There are certain things, certain technologies you need to know, but in pretty much all cases, the very essentials, the basics, are enough, in my opinion. Diving deeper is possible, and you might need to do it for certain jobs, for certain use cases, but to get started as a developer and to go very far as a developer, you don't necessarily need advanced knowledge in all these skills. And then there also are certain technologies or certain tools which you probably don't need to know at all unless you're specifically working with them in a certain project. For example, Docker or Linux. Sure, it can help to know about these things, and it might be absolutely necessary to know about these things, about these technologies in certain situations, but for many developers, it will also not matter at all. If you're not involved with setting up and configuring servers, and if you're not working on a Linux system, you really don't need any advanced Linux knowledge, in my opinion. You might not even need the basics in that case. And the same is true for Docker. It's a super useful tool. I like it a lot. And you can do very useful things with it, including that you can set up isolated local development environments with Docker, but it might just not matter to you. You might not need it. You might not get any advantage out of that. And you also might not need to use Docker and understand Docker to deploy applications because you might not be involved in any deployment process anyways. Therefore, this is another great example for a technology that can be super useful, but that you don't necessarily need to know, at least not in all situations. And I'm emphasizing this because, of course, in the internet, as always, you'll find lots of opinions on all these technologies, on all these topics, and you'll often read or hear that every developer must know how to do X or how to use technology Y. And at least in my experience, that is simply not true. There are certain essential tools like Git, which I would argue need to be understood by every developer, but even there, the basics are enough in most cases, at least in my opinion. However, of course, as I emphasized multiple times, it's my opinion. What is your opinion on that, though? And what is your experience on that? Which tool do you need to know, which I didn't mention here, because I just gave you some examples here. This was not an exhaustive list, but which tool or technology does every developer need to know? And what is your opinion on knowing Git and Docker and so on? Please let me know. I'm super interested in finding out, and hopefully I'll see you again in future episodes.